Hello and welcome to 90 East. We know that if you divide the distance travelled by an object by the time it takes to travel that distance, you can calculate its speed. A simple rearrangement allows us to make distance the subject of this equation, so that if we know speed and time, we can now calculate distance. This seems simple enough, but what if you're not given these values, but instead are given a distance time graph? Well, let's look at an example. Here we're asked to calculate the distance travelled by an object in 4 seconds. We have two ways of tackling this problem. The first is simply to substitute values from the graph and question into the equation. So let's do that first. The line depicting the journey in this example is horizontal, indicating that the object is travelling at a constant speed. The line intersects with the y, or speed axis, at 2 meters per second, so we know that this is the object's speed. Let's put that into our equation. We've been asked to calculate the distance travelled in 4 seconds, so that's our time. We'll put that into the equation too. And 2 meters per second times by 4 seconds is equal to 8 meters. So that's our first method. It's simple, it's easy to use, and it's effective. But, and this is a big but, it's only useful when speed is constant. Let's look at the second method now. The second method is to calculate the area under the portion of the journey line, that's this line, that you're interested in. In this example, it's the area within 4 seconds. So we could use this area or this area. It really doesn't matter. We'll still get the same answer because the shape, and thus its height and width, stays the same. Let's work through this example. The area of a rectangle is calculated by multiplying its height by its width. So that's 2 meters per second multiplied by its width, which is 5 minus 1 second. That is 2 meters per second multiplied by 4 seconds. And once again, that equals 8 meters. This second method, that is the area under the graph method, is great. And it's the one that we recommend that you use because it doesn't matter what your journey line looks like or even what portion of the journey you're interested in. As long as you can calculate the area, you can calculate the distance traveled. So just to review, if an object is traveling at a constant speed, you can substitute values from the graph and the question into the equation to work out the distance traveled. But if the speed of the object varies along the journey, you must use the area under the journey line or the portion of it that you're interested in to work out the distance that's traveled. As always, there are links to the written tutorial and worksheet in the description box below. We hope you've enjoyed this video. And if you've got any questions, please don't hesitate to either directly message us or send us an email to 90eastTV@gmail.com. Thanks, everyone.